Hi and welcome to the session. Today we will learn about properties of whole numbers. First of all, we have closure property. This states that whole numbers are closed under addition and multiplication. Let us understand this with the help of an example. Suppose we have two whole numbers, 6 and 2. Now let's see how whole numbers are closed under addition. So here 6 plus 2 is equal to 8, and 8 is a whole number. That means whole numbers are closed under addition. Now 6 into 2 is equal to 12, and 12 is a whole number. That means whole numbers are closed under multiplication also. Now we have a property that division of a whole number by 0 is not defined. Let's say the division of a whole number 7 by 0 is not defined. Next property is commutativity of addition and multiplication. This states that addition and multiplication are commutative for whole numbers. For example, suppose we have two whole numbers, 5 and 2, then 5 plus 2 is equal to 2 plus 5 is equal to 7. That means addition is commutative for whole numbers. Also, we have 5 into 2 is equal to 2 into 5 is equal to 10. That means multiplication is commutative for whole numbers. Next property we have, associativity of addition and multiplication. This states that addition and multiplication are associative for whole numbers. For example, suppose we have three whole numbers, 2, 4 and 5, then 2 plus 4, the whole, plus 5 is equal to 2 plus 4 plus 5, the whole, which is equal to 11. That means addition is associative for whole numbers. Also, 2 into 4, the whole, into 5 is equal to 2 into 4 into 5, the whole, which is equal to 40. So, this implies that multiplication is associative for whole numbers. Now next property is distributivity of multiplication over addition. This states multiplication is distributive over addition for whole numbers. For example, 2 into 3 plus 5, the whole, is equal to 2 into 3, the whole, plus 2 into 5, the whole. Next, let us see the identities for addition and multiplication. So, first of all, we have 0 is the identity for addition of whole numbers. That is, if we add 0 to any whole number, say 2, then we will get the same whole number, that is 2 itself. Now, let's see the identity for multiplication. So, the whole number 1 is the identity for multiplication. Of whole numbers. That is, if we multiply any whole number, say 2, by the identity 1, then we will get the same whole number, that is 2 itself. Now our next topic is patterns in whole numbers. Now we can arrange numbers in elementary shapes made up of dots. The shapes we take are a line, a rectangle, a square and a triangle. So first of all, we have every number can be arranged as a line. For example, let's take the number 3. We can arrange this as a line, and the number 4 can be arranged as a line like this. Now, we have some numbers can be shown or arranged as a rectangle. For example, let us try to arrange 8 as a rectangle. So, we can arrange 8 like this. This is a rectangle. Now, we can also arrange some numbers as squares. For example, 4 can be arranged like this. This is a square. Now, we can arrange some numbers as triangles. Let's see one example. Let us try to arrange 10 as a triangle. So, here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 dots. Now, we are left with 4 more. So, here are 10 dots and we have arranged 10 as a triangle. Now, our last topic is patterns observation. First of all, let us try to find out a shortcut method to multiply a number by the numbers of the form 9, 99, 999 and so on. Let's take an example. Let us try to multiply the number 74 by 999. Now, we can write 999 as 1000 minus 1. So, this will be equal to 74 into 1000 minus 1. So, this will give us 74,000 minus 74. This is equal to 73,926. So, this is how we can multiply a number by the number 999. Next, let us try to find out a shortcut method to multiply a number by the numbers of the form 5, 15, 25, 35 and so on. Let's take one example for this. Let us multiply the number 74 by 25. Now here 25 can be written as 50 upon 2. So this will be equal to 74 into 50 upon 2. Now first of all we will divide 74 by 2 and we will get 37 into 50. Now 37 into 10 is equal to 370 and we are left with 5. So we have into 5. So 370 into 5 is equal to 1850. Thus, in this session we have learned properties of whole numbers, patterns in whole numbers and patterns observation. So with this, we finish this session. Hope you must have understood all the concepts. Goodbye, take care and have a nice day.